Taurus.
Let's go. These are already shuffled. You got a Queen of Wands over there, Taurus. Somebody feisty. You're dealing with the male or female that's a Queen of Wands. Aries, Sagittarius, Leo, or Taurus. Maybe you're just looking good. Maybe you're feeling good. Maybe you're feeling yourself. Maybe you have a friend that gives you some advice that you can talk to. Go out.
Have some drinks with. Maybe.
We'll see if she comes back out in the spring. Wedding?
Are there some Tauruses that are out there or that are getting married? Maybe that fire sign woman, that Queen of Wands I've pulled out, is your wife or your partner or somebody you're interested in. Or maybe it's somebody that's coming between your marriage. I never read these cards in reverse. And this is not a card I'm going to pull because I haven't got the deck shuffled where I want it yet. But it came out like this again. I don't read these things in reverse, but if you can hear the song, so something to do with your partnership, your weddings. There may be some Tauruses that are coming up, getting married, having families and things like that. But then there may be some Tauruses that are going through something, either with a fire sign that's your partner, male or female, or you're just going through something in your relationship, period.
And if you hear the song that I'm playing, the song is called Get Out by Changing Faces, because the word that I got for
Taurus before I started doing this video was changes.
And I had a melody in my head, but it just wasn't to a specific song. I had a melody in my head,
and I had words in my head, but I couldn't quite get the song that had the words I wanted to play. Like, you know how you kind of singing it,
and you might tap into whatever song those words come from,
but I couldn't quite put my finger on the song that I wanted to play. And it was something old school. I felt like it was an Earth, Wind, and Fire song about changes. And I know they had that one that's like, the reasons, But it wasn't that, because that wasn't Changes, and
I couldn't really get the song
that would have fit
for you guys. But also, at the same
time, while I was thinking Changes in the lyrics, I thought of
Changing Faces. But I knew the songs they
had. I knew they didn't have any songs called Changes. So, but I said, you know what, let me pull Changing Faces. And this is
the songs that came to me to play for you guys. So I do feel like
some people are going through changes. And of course, these readings are for everybody. These are general. These are not specific to one Taurus out there watching, or one cross watcher. But I'm sure there are Tauruses out there that are going through good times. I'm going to turn this one upright. That are going through good times and everything like that, and everything's cool, you know what I'm saying? But then I'm sure there are those Tauruses who are going through something. So you guys are coming through to me, and you just may be going through changes. Now, changes can be good, and changes can be
bad.
In the end, changes always bring you to where you need to be, even
if it doesn't seem good at the time. So we're not going to look at
any of that as negative Taurus, but there may be some Tauruses that are just
going through some changes. And I'm about to get into
the reading. I'm gonna cut the music off. I do, because these decks are already shuffled. I'm just shuffling it again for your benefit on camera, because I know a lot of you guys do like to see that. And I'll talk about the astrology for a second. Because Taurus is having some big changes coming up. Some very big changes. So Taurus may be having some changes in their thought processes. How you think about things. How you see things. What you're into. Maybe you have some new ideas coming to you, Taurus, that you want to pursue. Maybe you want to get an education, and you guys want to increase your skills, or maybe you've been
maybe you guys have been doing something
for a long time and you kind of want to switch it up and
do something else. So that could be what's going on for you, Taurus, because the big thing for you guys specifically is the Uranus going into Taurus. Now with the Virgo
full moon or new moon, whatever the hell it was,
you guys
may have been going through some
difficulty, because we had that, and then we had Mercury retrograding in Pisces, and of course the earth signs train you. So some of that difficult energy may be coming over to you guys, as far as just
like communication
decisions you have to make. I wouldn't say
this is a good time to sign any contract deals or anything
like that. I mean, that's just regular
Mercury retrograde stuff, not necessarily in Pisces. But I have noticed
my Virgos may
be having a little difficulty right now, and so are my Capricorns. So that may
extend over to you too as well, Taurus.
Hoping it doesn't. But just to
kind of put you on guard of what's
happening with
the astrology. And then I'm going to do a separate video specifically about the eclipses
this year, the one in
Capricorn. You guys may have been feeling that as well, being our Capricorn sister sign, that lunar eclipse. And then we're going to have the solar eclipse in Cancer later this year in July, which may be a little nicer to you. And I'm extremely excited. I know some big things are going on in my life, because this eclipse falls like damn near dead ass on my birthday. So guys, tell me that that's not a big deal. I need to find like my
favorite,
you know, I
can read for myself, but it's always good to have a trusted reader or trusted astrologer that you trust. So I need to find like my favorite
astrologer or
reader online and pay them both
to do an astrology reading for me, a tarot reading for me. I need a numerology reading. I need
all of that shit going into this solar eclipse.
This birthday solar eclipse for me. And it's not just that it's in Cancer. If you guys didn't know, yes, I'm a Cancer. Rising and sun.
But the
shit falls like
almost dead ass on my birthday. So it's huge.
So you guys,
that may be a little nicer to you. Solar eclipses are thought to be
a little bit more beneficial than, or positive and upbeat than the lunar ones. And I know Capricorn had a hard time. I know, especially with Saturn in their sign, their ruler
in their sign, and Pluto there.
I know they're going through a lot of changes financially, just with people around them, loved ones, and things that have to do with just time and hard work. And those people that have been in your life for a long time, old friends, things that have some age to them, things that have been around for a while. So like losing people, changing jobs, you know.
Just really having a time. But I tell you, once Capricorn moves on into
Aquarius, eventually, you guys will be, Capricorn will be such a better sign because of it. And again, with you being Capricorn sister sign, you guys may have been feeling some of these things as well. But specifically for Taurus, the big thing is going to be, let me see, the big thing is going to be Uranus moving into your sign. Around the beginning of March, we came into the month with Uranus at the very last degrees of Aries. It did some retrograding, you know, and then it's now it's moving back into Taurus.
And I believe it was already in Taurus before, and then it retrograded, and now it's going back into Taurus.
So Uranus is going to be at the 0 degrees of your sign that started
on approximately...
They need to have lines in this ephemeris like a grid, because my eyes are just not that good. That started on the 7th.
And it's going to basically be at 0 degrees
of your sign to the end of the month, till around the 26th. Then it's going to be at the 1 degree and the two degree mark in April. So through your birthday, it's still going to be really close to that 0 degree mark. And happy birthday to any of the Pisces and the Aries who may be watching, because you guys have birthdays going on now. Happy birthday, Pisces, and then Aries coming up on the 21st of the month. Shout out to my dad.
Happy birthday to my dad.
He is a March 21st Aries. Rest his soul. Rest in peace.
That was my best wide entire world, and I try not to dwell on him too much, because I lost him almost 10 years ago, and it
probably it hurts just as bad as when it happened, you know. But
I just want to wish him a happy birthday
as we come into Aries season. But back to you, Taurus. So Uranus is going to be there, and I think there's going to be some major changes going on with the self, and not just as far as how you look, and anything that you may want to do or interest that you take, but like some reflection. All right, so like I was saying, in any event, I think it's going to have to do a lot with your the self-reflection, the
connection that you make with
others. I think it's going to get really, really mental and Aquarian, like for you, Taurus, and you. I think you're going to realize
some things that you learn through your relationships and
your interactions that you have
with others on a daily basis, or that you
have had over the years. Uranus is really going to bring, I believe, some change to your life. I think this next chapter that you're going into with Uranus in your sign is going to take you in a totally maybe different direction in life than you guys have been going. So get ready for,
you know, some upheaval, some changes, some challenges. And to be a different person on the other side, a lot like what Capricorn is going through with Saturn and Pluto in their
sign. Except, you know, Uranus is it brings heavy issues. It's things that's been going on for years. So these may be things that have been in the works. It's not, because like Uranus is so lightning fast too, it could be things that seemingly crop up out of the blue.
But the seed was probably planted a while ago. So that's going to be the big thing for Taurus. And if you guys want more information on that, all you got to do is Google
Transit Uranus in Taurus. Or you can even read it for the natal sign.
Just Google and you can find tons of information on Uranus
in Taurus. And you can find other in-depth videos about Uranus in Taurus. But as a Taurus, you guys should definitely watch that. So you got Mercury
retrograding in Pisces. Like I said, things getting
a little shaky, a little difficult for the earth signs, especially Virgo.
Gemini as well, with Mercury being that ruler, but I think Gemini is having it a little bit easier
than Virgo. They might just have some things that might be a little questionable, or information that
they might be a little hazy to the Geminis.
But I think it's definitely hitting the Virgo more, and it may be hitting the Earth sign too. So you guys may feel like your communication isn't getting crossed, and you really do
kind of have to be silent and go within
and think things through. And then later at the end of the month, it's a time to discuss things and move forward with whatever you were concerned about before Mercury, or at the time when Mercury went into retrograde. Venus is in Aquarius. So, you know, love might be a little out of the box. Love is not attachment. Love is, hey, I had things to do. You had things to do. Let's bring them together. Love is what can you do to stimulate my mind with Venus in Aquarius. Love is out of the box with Venus in Aquarius. So you may be experiencing some of that with your love relationships this month. Mars
is in your sign, Taurus. Mars is going to be in your sign all of March. It is going to go into
Gemini, 0 degrees
Gemini, on the 1st of April.
So Mars,
you guys may be
going hard when it comes to work. You guys may be working extra hard. Taurus, you are always
hard workers, but this month you
may be working extra hard, or Mars could
just have you freaking exhausted. So you may notice
how you're working hard because you're exhausted. And
Mars could be speeding up your libido even more.
I don't know if all Tauruses
are the same, but Tauruses, you seem to have a pretty good
libido. So you might be putting it down in the month of
March, okay? Okay?
Before Mars gets all intellectually and shit when it goes into Gemini and during your birthday month. We
have Jupiter is in Sagittarius. Jupiter is going
to
be
continue to be in Sagittarius all month. It's a slower moving planet, and it's going to go into retrograde in Sag around April the 9th. So, you know, depending on where
Sag falls for you guys, you may see your luck or your interest or
things that you want to know more about, or even your
spirituality take place or become focused around this particular area of your life. So depending on what house it is for you. So if
we're talking general and
Taurus is your rising sign, then that means Sagittarius would be your eighth house. So maybe because
just you can kind of take this. This is may pertain even if Taurus isn't your rising, because your sun still represents the self. It's still like first,
you know, kind of first house stuff. But if you are a Taurus rising, or just generally speaking, that means Taurus
is going to be in your first house.
Scorpio is going to be in your seventh. So then Sagittarius would in turn be on your eighth. So
with Jupiter in Sagittarius, you guys may be having
a lot of money that you're making through a spouse that's coming to you through other
people. Maybe family has left you money, but you may
be getting a lot of benefits right now through another party. So through your job, through inheritance, through taxes, through your partner, through your in-laws, through your partner's family. So maybe you guys are having some things and some benefits that are coming to you
that way with Sagittarius in your eighth house. Again,
Pluto and Capricorn. I mean, Pluto's in Capricorn,
and Saturn
is in Capricorn.
Saturn's going to, they're going to be there all month. Again,
slow moving planet. They'll be there for a few years.
And then they are going to retrograde
in April.
So if you thought things were crazy now, I mean, wait till these planets retrograde.
Pluto is going to retrograde on
April the 25th. And I thought I saw that Saturn was retrograding. Maybe Saturn is. Yes. And then Saturn's
going to retrograde on the 30th. So
both of those are going to retrograde in
Capricorn. What I'm hoping is that it gives Capricorn a little bit of a break, and you Earth signs a little bit of a break, not
to be under so much pressure. You get what I'm saying? So
let me just think for a second.
Capricorn 9, Aquarius 10, Aries 11, Taurus 12. So no, Capricorn would be 10. That's right. Capricorn 9, because the one. Okay, so Capricorn, if you are Taurus rising, would
be in your ninth house. Yes, because then
Aquarius 10, Pisces 11, Aries 12. So generally speaking,
if you're a Taurus rising, Capricorn is going to be on your ninth house. So you guys may really be going through something with someone at a distance, or something
at a distance, or like I talked about,
something that has to do with your education, you learning more, and
you discovering things about
your life and yourself and the way you want to live that may have
been different, or interests that you had that may have been different from before. So Capricorn
and Pluto, and I talked about about that in the beginning of
the video. Things putting you through changes when it comes to what you really think and how you feel and your beliefs and your values and things like that. So you may be going through that with Capricorn on the ninth, Capricorn and that Pluto in the ninth house.
So even if you're having like good benefits that
are coming to you and things like that, it's things that make you think. It's things, it's like you want something deeper. And I think that's just generally
what I mean by, you know, Taurus, you are going through changes.
I think you really want some changes in your life. We talked about Uranus going into your sign. We talked about that. And then
last but not least, besides the nodes, the nodes are still in
Cancer and Leo. But besides the nodes, let me just see.
Besides the nodes.
And the North Node is going to go retrograde. It was retrograde on the 2nd. It's going to go direct on the 14th. And then it's going to be retrograde again on the 16th. Direct on the 28th of the month. Then retrograde again on the 29th. And that's in Cancer. So, you know, Cancer for you being your third house. So you guys could have some things going on right now. Your focus may be on a family member. Things that are close to your community. Short travels in your community. And there may be a focus on a brother and sister and things like that going on with your North Node, with the North Node in your third house, or just revisiting things that have to do with home, family, kids, your parental lineage, or something from your past. So that's what you may be dealing with, Taurus. And then Neptune, of course,
is in Pisces. Neptune is
going to be in Pisces for a while. It's another slow
moving planet. It's going to take years.
So it's going to be in Pisces all of
March and all of April. And as we just
discussed, for you, Pisces is your blah, 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 11th
house.
Generally speaking, if Taurus is your rising sign, considering Taurus to be your first house. So Pisces is going to be your 11th house.
Taurus,
you're going through changes because you may not really know
who's really in your corner, who your real friends are, who your real family are, who your real loved ones are. You may be having some questions like that. You may be
making new connections, new associations, and maybe you are becoming a part of,
maybe what you're missing or what you're lacking is spiritual.
So maybe you could find yourself
being a part of Piscean type, Neptunian type things.
Spiritual institutions, you may want to start
becoming a part of those type of things.
Taurus, you want to start that BS all right.
Don't give me missed signals now.
Lord. But, Taurus, you know, with you, even when I see negative in the reading, I still see good. Like, you know, Taurus, is you guys hardly ever just get like a bad reading. Bad reading. And I have no idea what the hell I was saying before I stopped from that. So, yeah, Taurus, whatever you want.
Whatever happiness and fulfillment
it is that you're looking for is going to take a lot of hard work. And I'm just going to, I'm doing a general spread.
I just want to lay the cards and just talk
and see what comes to me from looking at them. That's
just what I want to do. And I'm sorry, you guys might not see everything. I have no idea what the hell the camera is looking at right now.
But I'll pull some more cards in a minute.
Let's see. So Taurus.
Taurus. You didn't get the message. Something happened behind your back. You did not get the message. The message did not come through. They did not talk to you before
they did what they did.
And everything, I was going to say was moving kind of fast. But maybe the communication coming towards you was actually moving kind of slow. But you went ahead with something anyway. But when you went ahead with something anyway and you were expecting a certain result or a certain thing to happen, it didn't. And it caused you to change your mind and rescind your offer. So, you felt very victorious.
coming out of a certain situation with no communication, no movement, not seeing anything eye to eye, or you felt like things were going on behind your back. So you took your shit and you moved forward, Taurus. And you said, hey, I don't have anything for you anymore. Or if this is what you were moving towards, I don't have anything for you. I no longer have an offer for you. So that speaks of Taurus maybe moving ahead with something without having all of the information. Maybe you guys left one relationship for another relationship. Maybe you had to ignore hearsay and talk because you knew it would make you not want to proceed. So, it's like you and someone weren't getting along.
You and someone didn't
see eye to eye,
but you've been
steady moving forward, and you still have love in your heart,
and you still wanted to love, and you still wanted to be victorious,
and you still wanted to have something
very happy.
But it didn't come easy. This came after a breakup. This came from not seeing eye to eye with somebody. And there could have been something that you didn't know. And threes
aren't always about third party. It's not always like that. I mean, I don't always get third parties in a reading. It comes up quite often. And you don't even have to ask yourself why. If you look around at your friends and couples, everybody's cheating, right? Okay. So that's why threes
and third party situations come
up a lot in the tarot readings, especially the love readings. But I say three party because I felt like something was being kept
secret. In a relationship, something was being
kept secret
in a relationship. And even though something was being kept secret and not being shown or presented to one or both of the parties in a relationship, somebody was still
having a good time.
Someone was still enjoying themselves. Someone was still
partying. Somebody was still gallivanting around with several women or several men or something like that in this relationship.
Or maybe someone stopped speaking to you because you were in a relationship.
Somebody stopped speaking to you
because you are partying
too much. You are drinking too much.
You got too much
going home and it's going on and this just is not the Taurus they know.
So maybe you guys have been
out of the home a lot. Maybe work has
taken you into these settings
where you
aren't at home maybe as much as you used to be. So you've had to travel to make your money.
You've had to
travel to make things work for your family. You've had to travel and you've had to work really hard
to give
people the life they want. You have to work really hard to be able to get that nice house and take care of the family and the kids and everything like that. And you don't mind doing that. You know, Taurus, you don't mind working hard.
But
is your hard work
being appreciated?
Is the hard work being taken for granted? While you
are working hard and you are manifesting because this is something that you wanted.
This is something that you've wanted. You've always wanted this happy family. You've always wanted everything. I mean, the Ten of Cups is
everything. The Ten of Cups is everything. And when you look at
this, it's like coming
from
maybe a partnership
and going into a family. So maybe
you wanted to go into a family environment or you wanted to turn a partnership into a family house.
Kids, the white picket fence, and all of that.
You know, or you could be coming from somebody and going to somebody that has kids. Maybe parents live with you in the home. There's something with the in-laws. We talked about the in-laws and things like that. Maybe
somebody that you know broke up or got divorced and out of this, somehow some money may have come to you and
your family. But I think
as we head out of the reading,
somebody's trying to kill the vibe. Some kind of money came in from your hard work or somebody's hard work. Some money came in, some offer, something that you've been working on for a long time came in.
To you, came into your family, and it was all good. Times were good, you partying, you having a good time. But going out of the reading, it's like, skirt. Hold up, we hit a snag. Because then you've just turned into an asshole.
Or you got this asshole person. Or you could have been on a brink.
You could have been on the brink of a divorce
with your partner.
I'm showing both people being emotionally hurt. Nobody getting what they
want.
Getting what you want, and then you're not offering somebody what
they want, who you're in a
relationship with, so everybody's unhappy. But
you go out, you work hard, you concentrate on work, and you bring that home to take care of your family.
And when you do that, now all of a sudden
everybody's happy, but you aren't happy,
because although now
everybody's happy, or maybe you needed some financial release. So you could have, what you could have been doing
may not have seemed good enough. And maybe your partner found something
somewhere else. And now you're looking back at it like, oh, hell no. And it kind of reminds me of those situations. I know you guys have seen movies or TV shows where it'll be a
couple, a guy and a girl.
And it's always like an issue.
If, say, the guy's out of work.
And then the girl gets her partner a job, or she hooks him up or gets him hired. It always hangs over the man's head because it's like, my woman got me this. You know, her boss likes her, so she was able
to get me hired. And men kind of resent that. So it may have been some money that came into the house from another
source, and that just totally pissed you off, Taurus, because you work hard and you do support your
family. And it just made you like, oh, hell no.
Or it could be another male air sign. And like we talked about, Uranus is moving into
Taurus. So you may have thought something was one way, and then you hit a snag with this air sign male king of
swords. Gemini, Libra, Aquarius.
Again, I get the idea.
Changes in a lot of this spread, basically.
Talk to me about...
Ooh, chest hard. I must have been feeling passionate. It talks
to me about
things not being
as they seem, or you going through changes because of something that you didn't know, either from a previous partnership or
current partnership. And I really do feel like it has to do with a third party. And because I have water signs so heavy in this spread,
the signs
that you're dealing with or what's going on in your life has to do with a
Cancer, a Scorpio, a Pisces. We talked about it could be a Gemini, Aquarius,
or Libra. And
again, these could be energies. I find that when I do love readings
and when I do tarot readings, a lot of time the Venus sign comes up. So you could be an air sign Venus, you could be a water sign Venus, you could be dealing
with somebody like that. Or this could be their sun, moon, rising, or any place in their chart where they have two or three planets, heavy energy in that particular planet or house. So I have a
feeling that either a
relationship you were in, or something about relationships, what makes you happy has to do with the Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. But, or
it could be what makes you sad, or it could be what you thought. Maybe you thought
there was some third party stuff going on with this Cancer, Scorpio, or Pisces. That could be it as well. Or maybe there's some habits or some,
my phone giving me the 10% battery and I ain't going to be able to get this thing to stay. It's going to take me 10 minutes to fool with it. Okay. So maybe that's the case.
Or maybe there's some habits or some something or some drinking or some partying that the person is doing that you're not really feeling, that you're starting to notice, and you really have to put your foot down and say, you're going to have to cut this shit out, or
I'm going to have to rethink what's going on here. The offer that I extended to you, and you so happy, and you
think you got a scot-free around
here, you ain't got the, You ain't got to be the person you were when we met. Oh, hell no. I'm going to take that offer right back. I'm going to take it back. Because it already took me a long time to give it to you. And then you going to act like that?
You going to act like
that? Is that you acting? This is what Taurus
is saying to their partner.
They kids, they parents, they
loved ones, whoever the spread is about.
You apply it to your life how you apply it to your life. This is your general, and I don't know you. Okay? I don't know you.
And she said, you going to act like that? Okay, I'm going to act like this.
I'm going to act like this.
And I'm going to act like this. I'm just going to pout. I'm going to be grumpy.
Tauruses, Taurus will have an attitude. And you can
tell by the way they act.
So they might be moping around and acting like that. But I feel like Taurus, you're in a place where you want
to work on things.
But what is going on? And another thing I see in this spread, just by the way the cards are breaking down, by the way I'm looking at them and by the way I'm reading them. My energy gets hyped when I
do these videos, guys. You just got to forgive me. Because I do these videos. Like
I don't see how some of these tarot readers, I know people get paid off of YouTube and
YouTube's great and all this shit. People get YouTube fame. They think they somebody. I don't know how people
kick out readings after readings after readings.
Like I catch a vibe and then I'll be
like, let's go. And then it's like, I can't stop talking. But anyway,
the other half of this spread,
what I also see in this spread,
it's like you move.
Okay, in this, well, we start out just to show you kind of the phases your life is going through, the cycles you're going through. I'm going to have to
speed this up before my phone dies. I think the 10% warning just came on, and that didn't take no time. It's like you moving away from
something that didn't
work, but
or some communication, there's
you were moving forward without being privy to certain information or communication. Or maybe you were doing something behind someone's back and they just didn't have the information, or they were doing something behind your back and they didn't have the information. So you were moving on and doing
good. It's all good. You were going in a bright direction. Things were
looking up for you.
But
the direction you were looking
at
might not have
had all of the opportunity that you were expecting,
or what maybe before you something you hit a
snag with something in your emotions,
maybe somewhere in here you are really hurt
about. It could be the water sign, the Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces,
or it could just be emotionally inside you're fucked up, but you
continue to
move forward to happiness. And I feel like you did find happiness. I did. But I feel like, unfortunately,
something about it was temporary. We go from the One of Cups. I mean, the Page of Cups. But there's one cup on the card. So you got the Page of Cups. Then you got
the Two of Cups. So it's a seesaw.
It's going down and up. And I know, Tauruses, you think guys like things consistent.
You gals like things consistent. And I just see a seesaw here, but you're staying steady to yourself and true to yourself and who you are. And
you keep moving forward, which is a good thing to do.
But sometimes you do have to stop and reflect
emotionally and have those tough conversations. And
because, you know, when you don't deal with things, it causes dis-ease.
It causes tumors and things inside the body.
So you have to deal with this
energy. But I see you just keep jumping
over it. You just keep jumping over it. And you still stand strong and you still proceed. Because you know at the end of the day, life doesn't stop. Your earth sign. You are
about the material happiness that is represented on this card. Even though this is not the Ten of Pentacles, a lot of the energy means the same. This is about the Ten of Pentacles. It's about being financially happy and stable in your family,
taken care of and building something, having built something on a solid foundation. But the Ten of Cups is about
the emotional side of that, the inner happiness that you get. Okay, you're
fulfilled materially, but what is fulfilling your spirit? And that's what I said in the beginning of the reading before I even started
this. I felt like Taurus, Uranus being in your sign, and maybe Jupiter in that eighth house and some other things that are going on with you are going to cause Neptune and Pisces are going to cause you to go into
your spirit and dig much deeper than you have been digging. Because even though things seem good, so then you come from the 10 back down to the Three of Cups,
which the Three of Cups looks all good and it's a party, But usually the next day at the party, don't nobody want to go to work. Everybody got a hangover. People looking for whatever the shit is called that you take for a hangover. They trying to drink again to get rid of the hangover. They ain't never drinking again, but then they drinking again. So it feels good, but it's no depth there. You're empty after you're done. You can't do nothing. You done for the whole day because you done party. So something felt good and something was good. There was some kind of party celebration of a relationship, of a family, of good times, of you finally getting your happiness, but it's just was short-lived. Because now you're either dealing with some negative Gemini, Aquarius, Libra, or some negative, controlling, just fucked up Gemini, Aquarius, or Libra energy. When you meet a
bad ass sign, you've met a bad ass sign. You know what I'm saying?
So somebody is just in a bad place
emotionally. They'll steal from you. They'll lie to you
with a straight face. All that kind of shit. You know what I'm saying? Or this may be you
turning from this person who was very... Because, you know, you guys...
I'm going to do these videos in a different way.
Because I really want you guys to start to understand and get these cards and see what I'm saying. But you go...
Or the energy in your life goes... You got a Six of Wands. Hey, he's had a victory. It may be a short battle. He won the battle. He didn't win the war. But he's prestigious. He's riding with his head held high. He is in a good position on this card. Then you have the Knight of Pentacles. Still a good position. He's still traveling. He's working hard. He's turned into the Knight of Pentacles. He's accomplished much more
than he is. He's yet to see his reward.
But he's on his way. And then you kind of get what you think you want and all of that. But then right in the row with the rest, it's funny. All of these came out in the same row. These are all male energy. They could be female
too, for my females watching this. But these are all male energy.
So ladies, you could also be dealing with an Aries, Sagittarius, Leo. That Queen of Wands came out
in the beginning. So Taurus men, you could be dealing with Aries, Sagittarius, Leo as well. This is
the Earth sign energy. I've already said you could be dealing with another
Capricorn, Virgo, Pisces.
And this is not Capricorn,
Virgo, Pisces.
Capricorn, Virgo, Taurus. And this was the air sign. I feel specifically Gemini, but it could be Gemini, Libra, or Aquarius. So you have a little bit of everything. For the Taurus men, I think you may be
dealing with someone more
fire sign
or air sign
or water or earth. It really could be any of the four. But the two
that you have most on this table are
the water
and the fire.
But we do have the lovers in the reverse, which is Gemini, and the King of Swords in
reverse. But if
these don't represent people, they definitely would be the energy.
So they could just have some different things on their sun, moon, or rising. It may not be their sun. That's the sign I'm saying. But water energy, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces is coming out very heavy. I feel like the earth
energy.
And then it's a toss-up between the fire sign and
the air signs.
But like I told you guys.
And the earth sign partners. Because I'm reading this as jet
energy. But maybe you're with the earth sign partner. I don't
feel like. If you're with the earth sign partner, I don't feel like I'm picking up their sun, though. It may be something else in their chart.
Which is
fire or water or air. Because I'm really not picking up a strong earth. Whatever.
So. All of these came out in
the same row. So these are all representations. They're males on the card. One's a knight, the other is a Six of Wands. But then the last one in a row, you've got two of these upright. And these are good cards for all intents and purposes, depending on the rest of the spread. These are good cards in general.
By themselves.
Standing alone, they are more than not good cards. But then you get the King of
Swords in reverse. And the King of Swords in reverse can be nasty. You don't want to see a King of Swords in reverse. Usually he's
no-nonsense guy. A guy that's friendly, that can get along with people. He can give advice.
He is a solid person that people may go to depend on. He maintains long friendships. But in the reverse, he is just an asshole. He's unhappy. He's unhappy with himself. And then you're looking at the whole thing like, damn.
What have I gotten myself into?
I'm looking back on the past 8 years, 7 years of my life and just saying, wow. Where have I been and where am I at? It's difficult. I'm going to have to end this tour.
This is too damn long. Y'all got to pay me for 45-minute readings. God damn it. But you did get these cards as well. Retreat, past life and worth waiting for.
So you're taking
a retreat from the marriage. You're taking a retreat from the relationship.
Or if you want to
work on things, because I think you're undecided about if you want to work on it or not right now. Even if you're not showing it, you got a bad inner attitude and you don't know what you want to do.
So if you want to work on it, that could mean get away. But I feel like
you're taking a break.
You need to take a bit break from everything. Even work might be getting on your nerves, because I told you you're going to be working hard towards. But the clarity that you need is
worth waiting for. And this has to do with a past life relationship. So what you're going through is karmic, basically, is what it's saying.
You need to take a break. Get your mind together. Get your
mind right. Because what you're going through is karmic. And you can't find your future until
you rectify or you
find your past or you understand your past.
I know you guys always hear
The saying that history
repeats itself, and that is true. It does repeat itself. And again, I don't even really have the time to
sit here and read all of these cards, because I could see what card I'm getting and know what the hell is going on. And Taurus, this is a little
crazy. That energy, that now that I'm speaking on this
energy, it's cropping up in the freaking reading. Because out of all the cards in this big ass deck that you saw me shuffle, that was shuffled before I got on here, and watch, I'm not drawing no more cards, but I'm gonna show you how they probably switch up if I take the next like couple cards off the top of the deck. So what we got? You see what I'm saying?
None of these are winter or earth cards.
These are all the sun, the star, the hermit. So guys, you could be dealing with a Leo, a Virgo, or an Aquarius. The dreamer,
that fire sign,
the Aries, Sagittarius, Leo, and then I got the Queen of Summer. So you got all the cards that would be thought of as positive cards, depending on how we read them. I don't know, I'll have to look at it. But damn, all your cards was earth, and then you got the three winter cards. So you got the Five of Swords. Not good. Sneakiness.
Communication. Everything I just said.
I'm not even going into it. I'll read you what's on the card, because I don't know how many more times I can say the same thing. Walk away from dishonest associations, realizing that what you thought you wanted isn't the best choice for your happiness.
Something that's not worth the effort. Guys,
you may have to leave something in the past too, but
you got
to
work it out first. You can't just walk away. But guys,
I've been saying in my videos, sometimes I just want to cry how much the cards relate to each other. I tell you some shit, and then I'll
pull a card and it says
exactly what I just said.
Didn't I tell you that, what you thought you wanted, you may not have wanted. I said that before I drew this card. I'm not spending 5 minutes on that. King of Winter. So this is this upright. I don't read these
in reverse anyway. So you got it upright and reverse. And I'm going to go with this reverse energy because I don't read these reversed.
So the King of Winter, it says get advice from someone professional
and objective. Public
speaking. Unemotional relationships. I told you you acting the ass.
You might not be showing your partner something's wrong, but something's wrong. And if you're not with anybody and you're single, something's going on inside. And if you're talking to people, hanging around people who are not giving you good advice, you want
to get away from those people and talk to some people that really, really care about you. Or if you just got to go talk to somebody, a counselor, somebody who knows nothing about your situation,
do you do that?
And then you got the Seven of
Swords. There is a better choice. Not seeing things
clearly. Really running away from the truth, guys. And I just talked to you about running from your past and ignoring things and keep hopping over the whole hurdles. I just freaking talked to you about that. Then, and I want
to give you guys a crystal healing card. And I want to do all of this before my phone cuts off, because I want to make sure my video saves. So I want to give you guys a crystal healing to help you with what you need to do this month. And I'm about to go into super
turned up talking.
Because if this
49-minute, 50-minute
video is not saved on my phone, I'm going to be pissed.
But you got the
Queen of Pentacles and the Ace
of Pentacles. So something new with Capricorn, Virgo,
Capricorn, Virgo, Taurus sign, female, or something you may be going through with that female,
something new,
a new direction, just something you're going through with
this earth sign, or with your money, or you could be newly single and that may be the new path that you're going down, in a nutshell. Sorry, I rushed that. I probably could
give you guys more, but I ain't got the time.
And last
but not least, I'm doing I have the deck just spread out right here. I don't shuffle it because I just bought the deck. I don't know what any of the cards are besides the three or four that I picked for other signs. So I'm just picking a random card, basically blindly turning my head and picking a card. And whichever crystal healing card that we get is a stone that you may want to invest in this month that'll help you. So go to your jewelry store. A lot of jewelers put stones and necklaces and things like that. Or go to your new
age shop or metaphysical
shop and get you this meteorite.
Taurus, lifting your ass up off the earth
and existing and feeling in the outer realm. That's what you're going to do this
month. Maybe you won't be as practical and grounded of a Taurus
and
so predictable as everybody thinks you are. You're going to show their ass. Do it, Taurus. Do it. Do it. So, meteorite.
What is it? Meteorites are extraterrestrial rocks flung from space. They've been
carbon dated to the
beginning of time. What you're going through, Taurus, is from your past. Soulmates from the beginning of
time. You can't wipe that away.
I.e., even older than our sun. So these
meteorites that hit the earth from outer space are even
older than our sun. Meteorites come in three forms: nickel iron, chondrites, and palisites. And the palisites are infused with radiant
peridot. Who needs it? Children of the stars. That is all of us. Taurus, you're connected to
something much deeper.
And I think you're going to find it
in this month and going forward
throughout the rest of the year. Where to put it? Wherever you gaze toward distant constellations, with or without opening your eyes,
Taurus,
you got to get into something deeper. Try stargazing. Look out into the stars.
Ask yourself, what's your connection
with the universe and with the high power, the one that we call God? And really go deep within yourself, Taurus. Because you're a very intuitive sign. You're very connected. You just have to tap in. When to use it? When you're looking
to conduct more spiritual energy.
Guys, I talked in the beginning
of
the
spread about it being a spiritual thing.
I did that before I pulled any card, just off of the astrology. Again, I'm thankful to the universe. I'm thankful to what we call the God energy. And I'm
thankful to the stars to bring me here,
to be with you guys, to bring these messages through. I am very thankful. Ashe. When to use it? When you're looking to conduct more spiritual energy, try nickel
iron meteorite.
When you're looking to chat with a friend in another galaxy, go to chondrite meteorite. And I talked to you about new
friend associations
being more spiritual, maybe getting into groups where you can find a deeper spiritual connection. And then it says, when you want to feel aligned
to that universal energy
that pulsates through everything, try palisite meteorite. So guys, you can pause this
video, you can save it, you can share it,
you can like it, if I've helped you at all, if even a little bit today, and get you some meteorite.
And I'm just gonna put this
here. I don't know if it's gonna focus for you guys, but just in case anybody wants to pause it and try to read the back of the card, I'm just gonna leave that there. So you just have to pause it. And I love you guys. Talk to you soon. Madam X. See ya.